What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the Durbin Compound. If you haven't met me already, my name is Devin Durbin. So today on the channel, we are doing a little review on the $8 tape measure from Craftsman. So the original reason why I started this video was because I wanted to talk about a little problem I was having with this tape measure here. Anytime that I buy a tape measure at a box store, what I make sure I do is I grab one of the tape measures in the back. So I don't want a tape measure that has been, you know, just gone through and people have been playing with it. It's been taken off the shelf and, you know, used for measuring around the store and then brought back to the display. Blase, blase. Maybe somebody has dropped it. I just buy the ones in the back for those various reasons. So I had bought one of the ones in the back. I just wanted a cheap tape measure that I didn't really care about. I could have just thrown in, you know, a toolbox, and I didn't really worry about, you know, beating it up or dropping it or something like that. Just a nice $8 tape measure. So before this video started, I had actually fixed this tape measure. This tape measure was stuck. I couldn't put it in more than 12, or I had about 12 inches sticking out of this tape measure, and I had extended it all the way out and let the spring reel itself all the way back in multiple times, and it still was just jamming up on me. So after I had done it the third or fourth time, it finally did good for me. So whatever I did and got the spring going, you know, I fixed it. But nonetheless, it was a little aggravating at first because I could not get this tape measure to go back in. So if you do buy a cheap tape measure, just keep in mind that they're not 100% foolproof. If you buy some of the nicer Milwaukee tapes or a big Stanley Fat Max, something a little bit more robust, you're gonna have a better spring, you're gonna have a better design, and these cheaper tape measures might get sprung a little easier. So the easiest way to do it is to take it all the way out to the maximum length and then just slowly retract it and make sure that spring, you're allowing that spring to catch up. If you let it bind up in there, it will, you know, hinder the, you know, retraction. So my initial very first time I pulled it out, it sprung on me. So naturally, I pulled the tape measure all the way out and let it spring back, and it still ended about a foot short. Did it again. Keep messing with it. No dice. So that is when I went and bought another one. So I said, it can't surely be every single tape measure is like this. So I went and bought another one and didn't seem to have any issues with this. I could roll it all the way out and make sure that, you know, it comes right back in, and it acts just fine. But the initial pull on this one, very first one out of the box, definitely did not work well. So if you have that issue, make sure that you extend that tape all the way out, bring it back slowly, and you can possibly save it. That $8, you get what you pay for on this one. The lock is nice. I like the green. The green sticks out. The white is cool, but there's nothing here on the bottom side. How much do you really use it? If you're doing a lot of overhead, yes, you could possibly use it, but, you know, is it necessary? No. And if you're looking for a cheap tape measure, this is one I recommend. There are a bunch of cheap tape measures out there. You can get all kinds of Lufkins or various brands like Stanley, Fat Max. I do like the Lufkins. I'm going to do a review on the Lufkin Black Widow soon here, so stay tuned for that. I just thought I'd make a quick video on this cheap $8 one, and beware that if you pick it up, it is, it's got a weak spring in it, so it doesn't always like to do its job. So I hope you guys like that review. I'm kind of just screwing around with, I would put this in the awesome tools under $30. This is not an awesome tool. This is a mediocre tape measure. I put this at about a 4 or 5. It's going to get you by. It will do its job. It probably will last for years if taken care of. But when you pull out that initial pull and it jams up, and, you know, it took me a while to get it unjammed. It's just one of those things that I don't like about it. So I shouldn't have to mess with it with a tool at first buying it. Should not have to mess with it. In a couple years, if it binds up and I have some issues with it, it only cost me $8. I throw it out. And there it goes. So I just threw it on the ground. Still works just fine. So we did a little drop test there. Looks like it landed right on the heel of it. So I just threw it on camera for you. Not how I usually treat my tools, but that was 100% candid there. So, yikes. All right, so it still works. It's still not bad. Make sure that I didn't kill it. I might have killed it. So, yeah, I might have just killed it. I don't know. It's still retracting just fine. The standout on this thing is only like 6 feet, so don't be expecting a lot. Hey, it still works. So, I'd recommend it. Go out and get it. $8. You can't beat it. You can beat it. I'm sure there's cheaper tape measures out there, but for the money, this Craftsman, the lime green one, is not too shabby. So I'm going to give it a thumbs up. I'm only giving it a 5 on my scale, but nonetheless, a thumbs up. I'd recommend it. It's going to go in the toolbox for those little jobs. Definitely not something that I would recommend to a pro that uses it every day and uses it thousands of times in a month. You know, definitely not a pro tool, but a DIY, just something to sit around the shop and, you know, use it when you need to measure little things, and a backup tape measure. Great for that. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope to see you click that subscribe button, ring that bell so you're notified of the next time I come out with a video. I'm publishing every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday at noon. I hope you guys liked my video. Give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down, whatever you're into, and we'll see you in the next video.